Hello everyone, welcome to Indian Judicial Service. Today we are targeting here question number 181 to 200. This is the part 11th of top 400 MCQ of Code of Criminal Procedure. Now question number 181. A stepmother can claim a maintenance under section 125 of CRPC from her stepson. Option A, the provided she is childless and widow. Option B, provided she is childless and her husband is incapable of supporting and maintaining her. Option C, provided she is childless, though her husband is capable of supporting and maintaining her. Option D, both A and B. So in this question, answer is here option D, both A and B. So first option is provided she is childless and widow. So childless, there is no child of her and there is no husband of her. In such condition, the stepson is responsible for maintenance. Now option B, provided that she is childless and her husband is incapable, he is incapable now to maintain her. That's why the child stepson is responsible to maintain her. So answer is here option D, both A and B. Now question number 182. The maintenance under section 125 of CRPC can be claimed by a legal bedded wife during a substance of marriage, by a divorced wife and who has not married. Option C, both A and B. Option D, only A, no, and B. So here answer is option C, both A and B. So in this question, under section 125 of CRPC, the legally wedded wife during the substance of marriage can claim the maintenance from her husband, and the divorced wife and who has not remarried is also able to claim a maintenance from her husband. So option C is correct here. Now question number 183. Maintenance under section 125 of CRPC cannot be claimed by a married daughter having attained the majority. Married daughter having attained majority, by a legitimate or illegitimate minor child, by father or mother, all of the above. So answer is here option D, all of, no sorry, here it is cannot be claimed. So option A is correct here, the married daughter having attained majority. So if married daughter is does not attain the majority, in such condition the father is liable to maintain her daughter, his daughter. But if married daughter having attained the majority, the husband is liable to maintain her, not father. So option A is correct here, not here D, because I forget here, there is cannot right here, that's why. Now question number 184. Who among us the following can claim the maintenance under section 125 of CRPC? Option A, a legitimate or illegitimate major male suffering from physical and mental abnormality. Now option B, the legitimate or illegitimate minor child. Option C, wife including divorced but not remarried. So in this question, answer is here option D, all these persons are able to get a maintenance under section 125. Here the option B, option A, legitimate and illegitimate child, but they are male, but they are suffering from physical and mental abnormality, that's why they are able to get a maintenance from their father. And option B here, legitimate or illegitimate minor child, minor is also liable, also able to get maintenance. Wife including divorce, not remarried, getting the maintenance under section 125. So option D is correct here. Now question number 185. The amount of maintenance under section 125 of CRPC is limited to 500 per month, limited to 1000 per month, limited to 5000 per month without any limit. So option D is correct, without any limit. Under section 125, the maintenance, there is no limit. The judge has power to give the, according to the status of the family and the economic background of the parties, he gave the maintenance. Now question number 186. Under section 125 of CRPC does not complete payment of maintenance allowance by mother to child, by husband to wife to husband, both A and B, neither A nor B. So here answer is both A and B. So does not contemplates the payment of maintenance allowance by mother to child or by wife to husband. But in recent case, Supreme Court decided that the teacher wife is liable to unemployed husband's maintenance. If husband is unemployed, there is no source of income of husband. So teacher wife means the serviced wife liable to give a maintenance to her husband. So this is the recent judgment. I forget the name of the judgment, but it's given by the Supreme Court. Now question number 187. Under section 125 subsection 4 of CRPC, who of the following cannot claim maintenance? By wife living in adultery, by option B, wife living separately by mutual consent. Option C, both A and B. Option D, either A or B. So here answer is option C. If the wife is living in adultery or the separation by mutual consent, both the ground of the non-maintenance under section 125. Now question number 188. Under section 125 CRPC, the magistrate has power to grant interim maintenance and expense of the proceeding. Option B, has no power to grant interim maintenance and the expenses of the proceeding. Option C, the power to grant interim maintenance but no power to grant expenses of the proceeding. Has no power to grant interim maintenance but has power to grant expenses of the proceeding. So here answer is option A. A magistrate has power to grant interim maintenance and expenses of the proceeding. The magistrate having a power to provide interim maintenance and also provide the expenses of the suit. Now question number 189. The monthly allowance for maintenance or interim maintenance and expenses for proceeding are payable. Option A, from the date of order, from the date of an application if specifically ordered. Option C here, from the date of application even if not specifically ordered. Option D, both A and B. So answer is here option D, both A and B. Now question number 190. The monthly allowance or interim monthly allowance can be altered as provided. So under section 125 subsection 5 of CRPC, under section 126 of CRPC, under section 127 of CRPC, under section 128 of CRPC. So here answer is option C. Under section 127 of CRPC, the monthly allowance or interim monthly allowance can be altered or changed by the magistrate. So option C is correct here. Now question number 191. An order for maintenance or interim allowance can be cancelled under section under a circumstances stated in under section 125 subsection 5, under section 127 subsection 2, under section 127 subsection 3 of CRPC. Option D, all of the above. So here answer is option D, all of the above. Now question number 192. The proceeding under section 125 of CRPC can be instituted where a wife is residing on the date of application, can be instituted where the husband reside or is residing on the date of application. Option C, where the husband and wife last resided. Option D, either A or B or C. So answer is here option D. The proceeding under section 125 is started where the can be instituted and the wife is residing and the date of application, on the date of application. Second year, the husband residing or residing on the date of application. Third year, the last residing of husband and wife. So all these options are correct here. So option D is correct. Now question number 193. The application for interim monthly allowance and expenses of proceedings is to be decided within 30 days of such of service of notice of the application to such person. Option B, is to be decided within 60 days of the service of notice of the application to such person. Option C, is to be decided within 90 days of the service of notice of the application to such person, is to be decided within 6 months of the service of notice of application to the such person. So in this question is here, the application for interim monthly allowance and expenses of proceeding is to be decided within 60 days of the service of notice of application to such person. So option B is correct here. Now question number 194. Under section 125 of CRPC, imprisonment of the defaulter is a mode of satisfying the liability, is a mode of enforcement only. Is option C here, both mode of satisfying the liability and enforcement. Option D, a person ordered to pay a maintenance stand absolved by his being sent to jail. So answer is here option B, it is the mode of enforcement of the order of maintenance. So answer is B here. Now question number 195. The period of limitation for execution of order of maintenance is 1 year from the date on which a become a due. Option A here. Option B now, 3 years from the date on which it become due. Option C here, 12 years from the date on which it become due. Option D here, 30 years from the date on which it become due. So answer is here option A, the period of limitation for execution of the order of maintenance. It is the limitation to execution the order of maintenance under section 125 here. So it is 1 year, the limitation is 1 year from the date on which it become due. Now question number 196. In case where an inquiry, trial or other proceeding have been conducted in wrong place. Option A, the inquiry, trial or other proceeding shall be void ab initio. Option B, the inquiry, trial and other proceeding cannot be set aside as void unless it has auctioned in failure of justice. Option C, in inquiry, trial or other proceeding cannot be set aside even if it has occasioned the in failure of justice. Option D, either A or C. So here answer is option B. Question is here, in the case where inquiry, trial or other proceeding have been conducted in wrong place. So in wrong place, the inquiry, option B here, correct answer. Inquiry, trial and other proceeding cannot be set aside. First of all, it is important here, it cannot be set aside as void unless it has occasioned in failure of justice. If it is the failure of justice due to the wrong place, inquiry, trial or other proceeding instituted in wrong place and it causes the failure of justice, in such time it is void ab initio. But if it is not the failure of injustice, in such time such proceeding is valid here. Now question number 197, the objection as to the lack of territorial jurisdiction of a criminal court can be taken before or at the time of commencement of a trial. Option B, can be taken at any time after the commencement of trial. Option C, can be taken in appeal for the first time. Option D, all of the above. So here answer is option A, can be taken before or at the time of commencement of trial. So the objection as to the lack of territorial jurisdiction of a criminal court arises at any time of commencement of trial. Now question number 198, under the scheme of CRPC, the original jurisdiction to take cognizance of an offence is vested in the court of session, option B, the court of magistrate, option C, high court, option D, all of the above. So the original jurisdiction in CRPC is court of magistrate. These two courts are appellate court, not original jurisdiction court, high court or session court. The original jurisdiction court is a court of magistrate. In special circumstances like section 199 of CRPC, is the session court having the power of the original court. But in general way, the court of magistrate is having a original jurisdiction to take a cognizance. Now, question number 199. The court of session has original jurisdiction to take a cognizance of offence by virtue of option A, section 190, option B, section 193 of CRPC, option C, 199 of CRPC, option D, 198 of CRPC. So here answer is option B, section 193 of CRPC. Now question number 200, the court of section under section 199 of CRPC has original jurisdiction to take cognizance on an oral complaint of a private person, option B, on an oral complaint of public prosecutor, this is very important person here, public prosecutor, option C, on an written complaint of a private person, option D, on a written complaint of a public prosecutor. So here answer is option D. The court of session under section 199 of CRPC has the original jurisdiction to take cognizance on the written complaint. So it is written complaint of public prosecutor. So answer D is correct here. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please click on like button and please subscribe our channel. Thank you.